I'm Tom Kemble. I am head chef of Bonhams Restaurant, and I will be cooking a scallop dish using Isle of Mull scallops with a cucumber and oyster emulsion, confit kombu, finger lime, cucumber, cauliflower puree, and a ponzu jelly. I was inspired to do this dish mainly because of receiving such fresh scallops, which I know sounds a bit ridiculous, but they were so fresh that when I was prepping these scallops, they were almost ripping themselves up. They were so lively. So I would keep them at really low temperatures just to stop the movement a little bit. But pan frying was a really aggressive way, I think, of cooking scallops, and it was damaging them. So it got me thinking about a more gentle approach. And this is where I came up with working a steamer into the cooking process. So the scallops are gently steamed, and then I want a little bit of caramelization and a little bit of smoke. So I got that by finishing the scallops on a griddle bar and just marking them at the very, very end. So you need a vat pack and a sous vide bag for this process. You want to peel two cucumbers and, using a mandolin, slice them to about 5mm thickness. Put the cucumber sheets into a sous vide bag with a touch of high quality sesame oil and a little bit of salt, and sous vide for 90 seconds. Cut the cucumber into small discs. Oyster and cucumber emulsion. Juice one cucumber in a food juicer and blitz in 20 oyster leaves. You want to soak 3 liters of gelatin and then carefully heat up the oyster leaf and cucumber juice, dissolving the gelatin into that. Emulsify with vegetable oil and season with Chardonnay vinegar and salt. For the confit kombu, we need to make the kombu cooking liquor. Take 300 grams of dashi, add 100 grams of silky, 80 grams of mirin, 200 grams of soy sauce, and 70 grams of glucose. Bring up to a boil and reduce by half. Now, using a reserve kombu from the dashi, cut the kombu into nice neat squares, maybe about half a centimeter each, and cook in the cooking liquor at around 70 degrees for 24 hours. For the ponzu jelly, bring up 400 ml of dashi, along with 50 ml of ponzu, 20 ml of soy, and kombu vinegar and dashi vinegar, maybe a teaspoon of each. Soften 2 liters of gelatin in ice water and weigh up the whole mixture. To set the jelly, heat up a small amount of the mixture in a pan to the boil, whisk in the agar-agar and cook out for a minute or so. Add the gelatin and then the remaining amount of ponzu jelly liquid and blow torch to take away any bubbles. Pour carefully onto a flat gastronorm tray, leave the jelly to set up and then refrigerate. And finally cut into discs to place over the scallops. Carefully open the scallops using a flat knife. Discard the skirt and membrane, dip into ice cold water to take away any grit, and lay on a J cloth. Steam the scallops gently for 2 minutes. I use a little kind of baking pin and I put that into the scallops, and it should be just warm to touch on your lip. So that's the kind of test I use to check the doneness of the scallop. When it is at that temperature, remove from the steamer basket and griddle mark on a griddle on high heat for 5 to 10 seconds, just to get a nice bar. Then brush with a little bit of butter and some soy. On the bottom of the bowl, put a tablespoon quenelle of cauliflower puree. Place the two scallops on top of that with a square of confit kombu and a few small pieces of finger lime. On top of that, drape over a disc of each of the ponzu jelly. To finish the dish, whisk the cucumber and oyster leaf emulsion sauce into the bowl and add a few strips of julienned oyster leaf. So the main flavor profiles on this dish is essentially cucumber, cauliflower, and seaweed. The acidity comes from this lovely ponzu jelly, so there's quite a few Asian elements, I guess, to it. And there's quite an interesting cooking technique with the kombu. So dashi, as you've seen, is used in the ponzu jelly and also in the cooking liquor of the kombu confit. The kombu confit provides a really interesting flavor kind of comparison as well. get quite licorice notes with it. The cucumber, again, those iodine flavors. The oyster leaf is a fantastic product. Instead of using fresh oysters, you get this amazing iodine oyster flavor from a green leaf, which I find really, really interesting, and adds some vibrancy to the dish when you make the cucumber emulsion.